Hey everybody, welcome to Construction 25 Garage Repair. I'm also known as Construction 25 Mikey. In today's repair video, we're looking at this my 2010 Husqavra 455 wrencher. I got it running since about other day, and I cleaned the tank out and put some fresh tank, a few in there, and if you guys think the carburetor definitely needs to be adjusted, but I'm not going to make a mistake by adjusting the carburetor on this fan, but it's been running fine. But let me try starting it again and see what, and show you what exactly what it's doing. When it dies on the bog, that means your primer bulb may be broken. See what? Yeah, that could be definitely our issue. Note that there's a fuel that's spraying from the carburetor's primer bulb outside of a chainsaw. But it may, it can definitely catch on fire, but we don't want the situation to happen to my chainsaw. So let me go ahead and get this cover off. And I got a primer bulb from my Craftsman 2006 model, which is I'm not going to be fixing. Which is I may have to get my Husqavra 240 back from my dad. If I decide to make a trade on it, on that Husky 450 with my dad. The primer bulb needs to be replaced. I got a primer bulb from the Craftsman. I got the Craftsman, which is a clone Poulon PP3616 primer bulb, which that might fit onto this chainsaw. Alright, so let's see if I can get these taps to release without I don't need to be cussing too terribly bad. Came out real easy. And make sure the fuel don't spray into my eyes, because that would sting. If you ever had gasoline in your eyes, but don't ever put gasoline in your eyes, because that can sting. Never put gasoline over your eyes or over your skin, because it could definitely tear your skin up real bad. So this perma bulb is definitely garbage because it's cracked. So it's getting replaced anyway. Alright, so let's measure out how much fuel line that it definitely needs for the carburetor to get to the primer bulb without having to mess up the fuel line terribly bad. I'm only stretching out only part of the fuel line, which it needs to go to the carburetor. Right towards, like its old fuel line, towards the bottom of the tank. Which is, it don't need to be replaced, so I'm going to leave that line alone. What do I do with these scissors? There's the rag, and when you need it, to wipe it off. See if the scissors are laying right there. I think I may lay them right by the counter. I may lay them right by the chainsaw. ideas of feline that might work? Don't even matter how big that feline is. Alright, so that's fixed. Now it's time to install a new karma ball. Gotta get this old broken feline out of that craftsman out of there. I gotta find a way how to get him. There we go. Alright. See if I can remember which port goes to the tank. The bottom is supposed to be going over to the tank, but the big one's supposed to be going over to the fuel cap. See how much grief we're definitely gonna get here. See what this situation is gonna make us deal with. Alright. I think this fuel line needs to be adjusted. Needs to be adjusted about a bit more. Got that installed. Now we can see how we're gonna get that fuel line onto it. Damn you! You primer line always give me hell. Knew the old primer bulb is not even that easy, but I know the parts, so I definitely got the right one for it. Damn. Gotta drain the gas out of the primer bulb. can't see how this is where we're going, but, because I got myself caught cussing on video. Now let's see how we're going to get through this project. That motor's double for the home lights shell cover. I was expecting worse, but I think I may not lie, but I think I may. May have to get a primer bulb off for the other old 455 rancher. See if that takes care of that situation. I think I might have to do it all over again. I think I may need to measure that fuel line, just like the old one with the other one. I find my scissors and cut it off at the right moment. That looks like I need to try my best to shorten it. Ah, shit. This big fuel line goes to the tank, to the fuel filter. That sucks it. I don't understand how to get the fuel line into the saw. Shit. This is a skinny fuel line. I don't know why it has to be a skinny fuel line, but I'm pretty sure the part sold is never get a bigger primer bulb. This is never going to make me mad or pissed off because it's on video. Because I think I might have lost my scissors. Not. I'm not sure where my scissors are, but I think I might have lost them. There's scissors. Yeah, baby. Now let's see how we're gonna get through here. There we go. Yeah, baby. Nice, done onto the project right there. Now it's replaced. This will make the saw run fine. But the old permabob wouldn't because it was cracked. Okay. Maybe sometime, maybe accidents do happen. If it does come off again, then we'll switch it out from the other Husky 455. Anyways, we may go ahead and try it right now after I get screws in, and we'll see how it make the difference. I like to think of it, it did. Let me get screws secured and we'll fire him up and see what he does. We may not be able to try to work on the carburetor, but it may don't need any carburetor adjustments to work on him. Fingers crossed. Something ain't right with it. Too lean. The fender cover needs to be adjusted. That's probably why, because it ran out of gas. But at least the permanent bulb didn't come out. Didn't come out of it this time. Let me see if I could try to get it tuned up just right. No, I can't see it because that stupid thing on there. Oh, well. At least we tried. At least I tried to run right. I like my Super XL and the newer Husky 455. Still got the new 455. I'm not gonna sell it. I'm still gonna keep it around. Works fine for me, but the old one isn't. But I'm sure the other one's got a carburetor that works fine. Well, there's the repair video on the Husqvarna 455 Rancher. But we tried, but at least it didn't come off. Its parts will be coming next week while my dad gets off work. I'll have a video of it soon. Alrighty. Thanks for watching.